problem is, I'm a believer in tough love. And unfortunately, tough love is this, that if somebody's an alcoholic, the real answer is if they come home and they fall down on the porch and they're laying in their own vomit, is making sure they're not going to die, but leaving them there so that they have to wake up and see the reality of where they are, so hopefully they hit bottom so they're motivated to get out of the hell that they built for themselves. And Kamoy facilitated with these other, with the pipes and the clean needles and everything else, and maybe the drugs or alternative drugs, you're not solving the core problem.
Yeah, like I said, though, the complex thing here is that people hit rock bottom over and over again, and they tell the story in a different way. But the evidence is it's kind of hard to quit addiction. We want people to stay alive. We don't want the sentence for addiction to be death, like Philip Seymour Hoffman or stuff like that. We want them to live another day for the chance to get...
Do you want the government to check the purity of heroin? Do you want the government to check the purity of crack that's being sold on the street?
I think it would be far more pragmatic and far more sensible that the government provided drugs in a way that was much safer.
You want the government to become a drug pusher and give people free drugs so that they can get wasted every day.
No, I just want a practical solution, more like in places like Switzerland, where you kind of cut to the basis of this. Where you cut to the basis of this and you think, and in this city, conservative Christian mayor that went along with this thing because he wasn't bound up in all the kind of bleeding art stuff. He just looked at this from a practical point of view and thought,
I'm sure you're a very nice man, and your heart's in the right position, but they're not solving the problem. The problem of addiction remains, whether it's the drugs you give them or the drugs they get on the street, or whether they smoke it in a Coke can or a pipe.
Well, in this city, because of the things that we've done that are cheap and cost-effective, life expectancy among this group has gone up by a decade. The spread of HIV has gone down, saving money. In your city, things, as you say, you're seeing this stuff on the street because you take a different attitude. You're spending a lot of money chasing people around, jailing them, and you're not getting it.
This is
you're not getting any better results, unfortunately.
The socialist state of New York. It doesn't get any worse.
You are